Selby, top of the ranking. Stuart Bingham, his closest pursuer.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First frame, Stuart Bingham to break.
It's going to be Stuart Bingham to get us underway. He's played quite a bit of snooker last month. Lost in the semis in Shanghai to Selby. He was also a semi-finalist at the English Open. Of course, that was another thriller. He lost 6-5 to Liang Wenbo. Selby runner-up to Ding in Shanghai. And a semi-finalist at the European Masters. So both players in form. This should be a really good match. And Joe Johnson is going to enjoy it with us.
Yes, you bet. And he looks happy, doesn't he? The jester. Yes, as David said, Mike Selby won the last meeting. But only just. It's 3 years since Stuart Bingham has beaten Selby.
Yeah, Stuart Bingham still looking for his first title since becoming world champion 18 months ago, but he's playing with much more freedom, I think, this season than last when all the attention was on him. And Selby has a different sort of pressure, being a second-time world champion. It's not the same as when you've won it the first time and everyone's waiting to see your progress. It's almost like he's sort of proved himself now. He's won it a second time.
Don't think it'll be the last one. Such a great player. And the longer the match is, I think the more consistent he is. Well, he'd like to play that red in the balk area and keep the game flowing. Doesn't want the safety play to be down this end of the table. But couldn't really see enough of the red. And he's left a red to the right middle. It's never easy. Raise of the hand for the lucky kiss. But again, there is a red to the right corner. Easy safety from the red by the balk line.
Whatever happens, Stuart Bingham will be in the Champion of Champions, even if he doesn't win the tournament, because there's two places left, and on the one-year list he's going to qualify through that, although the qualification process for that has been controversial, to say the least. It seems to have changed by the week. Surely better just to have a system and stick to it. That's a mistake.
Yes, the double kiss. Could have took the red on. So that good safety that Bingham played, he refused the long red himself. It's afforded him a chance.
One.
Applause for the first red potted.
The two semi-finals he lost recently, to Selby in Shanghai and to Liang Wenbo in Manchester, he played so well in both of them. The Liang Wenbo match in particular was a classic. Really was. Brilliant. Snooker from both of them.
Eight.
Just came up short both times. Lost in deciders. Must be frustrating. But at least he knows he's playing well.
Just looking at this red above the black. Seeing where he wants to be on it to the right corner, but he hasn't got the option of going into them. A little heavy.
16.
Maybe he can open a few more reds here. Screw up for the blue. Stuart had a day to recover from that thriller with Michael Holt, when both players had lots of chances in the last frame. And that's a mistake.
23.
Wanted to miss the black, come round for the blue. Not happy.
Green ball.
Just 23 points from that good lead.
Stuart Bingham, 23.
That's another safety error from Mark Selby. Two on the bounce. Very unlike Mark Selby. But another chance for Stuart.
One.
The red just below the pink spot, available to the right corner.
Six. Seven.
Well, if you played for the blue, he's coming a little too far. Pink and green available, and the red in the balk area makes it a little bit easier. To leave an angle on one of the colours to try and disturb the reds. And that's maybe why he didn't take the green or pink.
Ten.
Oh, he's a little far. And that's a poor positional shot from Stuart Bingham. He had such a large margin there. The red just below the black is available, but it's difficult to get to that red. It's a good attempt.
13.
Just too far. And that's a good recovery shot. And this time he has got the angle on the blue to disturb the reds. Well, he's pushed the black a little closer to the cushion than he would have wanted. Can't quite see enough of that red. Well, can he see enough of that one? He has got the other one with the rest. Looks like he can just reach it, full stretch. Well, he was a long way from that.
Stuart Bingham, 19.
Has he been fortunate? Yep, I think he has. Well, doesn't get any better than that.
One.
And he knew he had the pink over the middle, but look where the cue ball's landed. It's as difficult as it could be.
This was a cracking pot, but again, Selby's safety wasn't as good as it could have been. His safety so far in this first frame has not been of his usual very high standards.
Seven.
Well, is he on any of these?
Yeah, I think he's on the reds just to the right of the black. Just coming around to see if the black goes to the left corner, which would make things a lot easier if it does.
Eight.
Well, great chance for to win the opening frame here, and he looks sharp, Bingham. But as I say, Selby just a couple of for him, not so good safety shots. Cracking red though to get in. Bearing in mind it's only the first frame, it'll make him feel good.
15.
And he would have seen the start Ding made yesterday, going 6-0 up
16.
Against Judd Trump, and really putting the match away pretty much in the opening session. So even though this is a long match, you can do some real damage early on. Two snookers needed.
Plus a frame ball.
33.
Yes, Selby has not potted a ball in this opening frame.
And he's played three poor safety shots.
I think this is why Bingham needs to pot this. He doesn't want Selby to get table time. He wants to keep him cold in that chair.
Yeah, so also wants to get his eye in. A nice little 50-odd break here would do that.
31.
Stuart Bingham has won 5 tournaments in China, 4 Asian Tour events, and the big one was the Shanghai Masters 2 years ago. Both of these two are great foot soldiers. They will play in just about everything. They don't mind travelling, and they don't spend all the time complaining.
38.
Far from it. They both love the game. And you can just see in Bingham's body 45. Language, he looks more relaxed this season than last season when he did have all the scrutiny on
46.
Him. He's still got plenty now. He's world number 2, one of the best players in the world, but it's not like he's looking over his shoulder and conscious of the fact that he knows his opponents are playing the world champion, they're raising their games.
53.
Examining his results. That's all gone now.
55.
So the break ends at 58. Needed a few chances, but took them nicely. Long way to go. It's best of 17. Stuart Bingham leads Mark Selby 1-0. Stuart Bingham 1, Mark Selby 0. 8 frames to be played in this first session, possible 9 later on today.
Thank you. Frame 2, Mark Selby to it.
There's about 187,000 between them in the ranking. Selby number 1, Bingham number 2 in the provisional standings. So if Bingham did win this match and win the tournament, he'd eat into that, but Selby would still be at the top of the list, as he's been since February 2015.
Well, that was a half chance, and so is this. Black tied up for the moment. Yeah, good shot.
One.
But overscrewed it. Had to play it with screw to hide the red to the left corner. But just a little bit too much. One. And a good pot just affords him 1 point. Bingham shouldn't leave anything from this easy escape. Good length on the cue ball. Important to keep as much pressure as you can on your opponent with good safety. Oh, struck that well. Struck that very well. And very nearly got in behind the yellow. Well, there's a red to the right corner. Stuart just coming down to have a look to see what he would leave. He took the red on and missed it. Looks like a free go, this. Oh, missed it by a long way. And I think he may have been fortunate. That red came back across the table and blocked the red to the right corner. He was on the red to the right corner for a second. Very fortunate. Again, that's not a good safety. Colliding with the brown. May have left another free go. And this time it goes in.
One.
The wrong side of the pink though. It's got to be the black if he wants to keep the break going. Could play the pink to the middle with a lot of topspin in and out of balk. Try and disturb something. Or maybe he could screw across the table. Something like that. He's going to have to be accurate though.
Seven.
Well, he has got the cue power, Stuart Bingham, to be able to screw that cue ball into the reds and try and bring it out again with a lot of action on the cue ball.
Eight.
And again, just overrun. Couple of inches slower, easy yellow with an easy red to follow. The pink is in the way of coming around the two cushions if he plays to pop the yellow into the green pocket. An excellent attempt to get onto this red, and he's managed to do so. Now if he can get the right side of the blue.
Eleven.
Good pot, the right side of the blue, and that red will go to the left corner, the one by the pink spot. Left it short deliberately so he could open more reds in potting this red.
16.
Although he could have done with just coming another couple of inches, he wouldn't have needed the rest then. So this not quite as easy as it should have been. And that will do nicely. Brought a couple of reds out there. Should be able to just stun the cube, stun the pink in, hold the cue ball for the red on the cushion. And he's had to work for these so far.
20th.
And he's getting that. And now he's got the angle to play the cannon to the reds, try and develop some more. Terrific break builder, Stuart Bingham, heading towards 300 century breaks in his career. He's on 298 at the moment. Delicate little shot, holding for the pink into the middle, and this is beginning to look good.
He looks the more focused of the two. Selby's played a couple of, for him,
38
below par shots.
39.
And although this is a long match, Stuart Bingham knows that if this is a period where he's feeling more comfortable with the two, he's really got to make the most of it, because you can guarantee at some point Selby will start to play well.
46. Yeah, I kept saying that about Judd Trump yesterday, but it just didn't happen. And the likelihood is that Selby will hit a patch.
47. I think Trump's problem, actually, he did start to play well at the end of the first session, but then it stopped. He had two big breaks. He'd like to have kept going, but of course it doesn't work like that. I think, though, he was also there's some residual tiredness from all the snoop he'd played of late. But this is looking good for Bingham. That's a delightful little cannon, and he's got the frame at his mercy now.
54.
Yeah, that worked out very well. Knew what he was doing there.
55.
Made sure of getting the right side of the blue. So needs another red after the blue.
6. Selby's potted one ball in the first two frames.
That was the one he needed. Now he'll be feeling good now.
68.
Two frame lead.
69.
There are 15 players who've made 300 or more centuries in competition. As Joe says, Bingham's on 298. This is a chance to get to 299.
76. 77.
Well, he's playing like former world champion. World number two.
84.
Striking the ball so well.
85.
I've always rated Stuart Bingham for a long time, even before he made it. Always rated him. Great cue part. Got every shot in the book. And just 92. Proved how good a player he is. Last 3 or 4 years.
93.
Well, he's proving it again here. And this black for his third century of the week.
100.
So it's been incredibly one-sided so far.
Well, it will cut to the middle. It's a tough one. It's a tough one. It's a tough one. Go on.
105.
Great shot.
Well, it just shows as well how fast the cloth is. I mean, at one point you think that's getting nowhere near the pocket.
109.
Just kept running, didn't it?
Bingham's just been knocking on the door last month in tournaments. A couple of semi-finals didn't go his way. Maybe this one will. He's made a great start. Lovely break this. Clearance of 127 from Stuart Bingham to take early command of this semi-final. First to nine will play Ding Junhui in the final. Bingham leads 2-0. Welcome back to Daqing in China. Second semi-final underway in the International Championship. And Stuart Bingham, good value for his 2-0 lead over Mark Selby. He's just had 127 clearance. And Selby's only potted one ball in two frames.
The third frame.
Was a good
Stuart
one.
Bingham.
True, but he's still 2-0 down. There was a spell yesterday where Trump failed to pot a ball in four successive frames. Ding racked up 377 points without reply.
Thin cut to the right corner. Caught it much too thick. That's another poor safety. Might just be tempted by this red now that he's got his cue arm going. But there is danger in taking this red on. Where's it going to finish? Not good for Stuart Bingham. So a chance now for Mark Selby.
Yes, and this is what he's been looking for, I think, just to settle himself down. Just a couple of easy balls for him to get going.
One. Put your phones down. Eight.
That's not the best positional shot. He's left himself a little bit of work here.
Nine.
Nicely played though. Just screwing off the pack of reds gently. How has he managed to get that pink in there?
Thank you. 15.
Harder. I have to go in and out of balk. Looks good. Choice of three reds. That's what he played for.
Thank you.
and a hit it.
29.
So gonna have to go up for the blue. Choice is now whether to go into the more play for the loose one. It looks a natural to go into them. Just miss the pink and he'd take that red towards the left corner. Lots of left hand side on the cue ball to get low on the black to open the reds. 43. And it could have been better. Has a red to the left centre.
43.
But he's not directly behind it.
44. Just.
And they like that one.
Mark Selby already a winner this season. The Paul Hunter Classic was ranking title number 8. Looking 49. To reach his 18th ranking final, though, so he's lost 9 finals and won 8.
50.
Although, of course, most of those he lost were to great, great players, not least Ding in Shanghai recently.
57.
58. So needs one more red, so doesn't really need to go into that pack of reds. It's got the angle to do so. Could have finished 65. On something easier.
65. Still needs red in the colour.
66.
Well, where's it going to come from?
Well, that's frustrating for Selby. Just one ball away from clinching the frame.
Yes, he could try and put the black on the cushion. And that would make things very difficult for Stuart Bingham. Okay, he'd leave a red to the middle. But the black would be on the cushion.
Mark Selby, 66.
So, he's left the red to the middle. And Bingham's got the angle on the red to try and bring the black into play. And maybe worthwhile not playing to pot the red, but playing the cannon. He's played to pot the red. He's got the cannon. Wow, what a shot that was.
Well, this could be a very significant early moment in this match. Bingham needs all blacks and the 6 colours to win by a point. Oh, we needed the black first, though.
Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Incredible. Incredible. I was about to say, if he gets 5 reds, 5 blacks from there, be a minor miracle the way the reds are.
Well, the black has kicked. That's the first thing to say about this. it's still gone in the middle. He sort of half apologised, but he was unlucky in the first place. You can see the mark on the black.
Yeah.
Stuart Bingham, close.
Eight. Selby's saying, no idea how you got that nickname. He's referring, of course, to Ball Run.
And I'd imagine that Mark Selby would start pushing the Reds down the other end of the table. Starting with that one. I think he's left the red to the ball corner, trying to tuck the cue ball in behind the pink. And that should make sure of this frame and get his name on the board.
Yes, it was a nice 66 that Selby made. Bingham had a half chance there to certainly make the frame closer. It's been good stuff so far. If you are just joining us, I know it's early in Europe. Bingham 127 clearance in the second frame, his highlight so far. And remember, both of these players will be in Guangzhou next week for the new China Championship. Big invitation event where the first prize is even bigger than here. It's 200,000. We'll have live coverage from Tuesday of that.
Eight.
Be good to see a new invitation event where the focus 13. Is on quality rather than quantity. Just 16 players.
14.
This tournament had 128, but we've ended up with the world's numbers 1 and 2 in the semi-finals here. Ding, the world number 6, waiting in the final. I bet Ding wouldn't mind a 9-8 here between these two.
18. 22. Twenty-four. 27. 31.36. 42.
So it went slightly wrong on 66 when he lost position, but Mark Selby still winning the frame comfortably. His first frame of this semi-final, and that'll make him feel a lot better now that he's settled down. One frame to come then before the first interval of this match. Stuart Bingham leads Mark Selby 2-1. 2-1 to Stuart Bingham. Mark Selby winning the third frame, and this fourth frame will be the last before the first interval. Remember, it's eight frames they play in this first session, a possible 9 to come later on today.
That's all right.
Jan Verhaas is the referee, setting them up for this fourth frame.
Thank you, Mark. Fourth frame. Mark Selby to break.
That's an attacking safety shot. Opening the reds up. Could have clipped off them thin. Yeah, it's only just missed the black. And that's all he needed to do. Stewart contemplating on taking that red on by the blue. If he could attempt that red and play the cue ball over towards the middle pocket, shouldn't leave anything. Except the red is playing on. Could have been a frame winner had it gone in. That's a terrible safety shot from Mark Selby, and it's so un-Selby-like not to get that cue ball close to the ball cushion. And another half chance this for Bingham. And the way they're playing these two, she get in, consider it a frame-winning chance. Yeah, good pot.
One.
Played onto the black. And although it's not a gimme, you'd expect him to pot it. Well, he's just had a look to see if the black will spot, but I don't think it will. But because the red's to the right of the black spot, that red would go to the right corner. The black will go behind its spot, and the red should go to that right corner pocket.
Eight. Nine.
A little early to be playing for that red on the cushion. 16. A careless that from Stewart to leave himself hampered over the red. Potted it a little thin, and that's why he's lost the cue ball. Yes, it was
Stuart Bingham.
The first shot on the black, the position on the red, that left himself hampered. And he'll be disappointed with that.
Well, it was an illustration there of how when just the slightest thing goes wrong, it's very hard to put it right again. He lost ideal position and ended up being left with that pretty nasty pot on the black, which he's missed.
And it looks like he's left a red to the middle. I thought he'd got it safe for a moment. But that red's gone in the middle, and it could be costly. That poor positional shot from black to red.
Well, Selby is the master at seizing on the crunch moments, and it's worth reiterating that there's an interval after this. So were he to make a frame-winning break here, Stewart Bingham would have that 15 minutes to think about what's just happened, rather than getting straight on with the next frame.
He's played for the red on the cushion, but he hasn't left the cue ball in a good 16. Place. It's pretty straight, so this red now tough. Played it well, with the right hand side on the cue ball. Reverse side, it's called. And that's opened things up very nicely indeed.
24.
Everything available. The wrong side of the blue, so got to go in and out of balk. It's looking good. It seemed to slow down a little bit, that cue ball, but it's finished up very nice.
Potted one ball in the first two frames, Mark Selby. And might not have potted any at all in this one, but for Stewart Bingham going wrong unexpectedly.
39. 46. 53, 54, 61.
44 in front, another red and a black, 52, the lead with 51 on. And he needs one more red. Either way, it's going to be 2-2. Barring some sort of catastrophe here. 'Tis all he had to do, which was punish the mistake. And that's all it was. It was one very slight error.
68.
But it's been really costly. Or has it? Or has Sadly. It?
Well, 68. I was with you a couple of moments ago. He could have played for the black, which would have left 52 in the game. And because the reds were closer to the cushion, that's why I thought he would have played for the black. But he played for the pink, needed one more red. And what? This could be a brilliant steal for Stuart Bingham. And they are available.
Just can't believe he's missed that red, Mark Selby. Usually so reliable.
He's over hit it.
8.
Wanted to be going towards the black off this red. 8. Yeah, normally so reliable at shots like that. Wasn't a difficult red. But you never know, it could have just been in his mind that he should have been playing for the black, or could have done.
And I think even if he does win the frame now, Selby, which he still could do, it's just taken the shine off it a little bit, that slip-up. A little knock to his confidence. Remember, Bingham can only tie at the moment.
Nice.
Nice angle on the black to screw in behind this last red. And that's a better speed.
16. 17.
So the black and the six colours, and it's a re-spotted black. Selby had the frame one.
Well, three ways of getting to the yellow here. Stun straight up past the pink, screw to the cushion, and stun to the left cushion.
Overscrewed
it. It shouldn't be a problem.
29.
33.
I'm sure Bingham would have expected Selby to win the frame when he was in on 68. I'm sure Selby fully expects Bingham to pop pink and black and force the respot. So black, and the black comes back on.
Stuart Bingham, 51.
Yeah, he did what he had to do, which was clear the table with 51. So Jan Verhaas will spin the coin. And a big moment because the interval's coming up, and Selby in particular will feel now that,
Stuart, would you like to
you know, it really should be 2-2.
Tails. It is tails. Your choice.
Pardon. Bingham wins the toss, puts Selby in.
Quietly, please. Thank you.
So, is it going to be both balls on the side cushions? Or the black up and down? Two side cushions. Well, if he sends the black around the angles, it's got a chance of going in that right middle pocket. The only problem with that shot is there's going to be a lot of distance between the balls now. And the next safety shot for Bingham should be difficult. Pacing. He doesn't like it. He thinks the cue ball's going close to the pocket. If he takes the pot on.
Well, you consider the ready missed for the frame. He knocks in a fantastic black. Mark Selby delighted that after all that, he wins the fourth frame on a respot. And from 2-0 down, he levels up at the interval, all square. 2-2.
Stuart Bingham to break.
Stuart Bingham to break in frame 5 of a possible 17. He led 2-0. It's now 2-2 in the second semi-final of Snooker's International Championship. Well, he just sort of half holds his hand up because he's covered the red with the yellow.
Yes, brought the red down the table. Fully expected Mike Selby to be able to pot that red. Cannon on the green has tempted Stuart Bingham to this red to the right corner. just needs to pull it back a couple of inches. Never an easy shot. And he's... Has he? I was about to say he's left the red on, but I'm not so sure. Applause for a good safety, trying to get in behind the green. Caught it just a little too thick. And this time he does leave a red on, although he has pushed the black safe. Nicely controlled shot. Cannon to red leaves him on the pink to the middle. Deliberately held the pink spot. Makes it a lot easier.
Seven.
Pink going onto the black spot.
Eight.
Pink will still go to the middle, or he could play it for the blue.
15. Well,
that certainly opened things up, and it's brought the black out as well. That is a bonus. All of a sudden, this mini break has turned into a frame winning break.
It's
so important now to really concentrate, because it looks like the hard work's been done, but in the previous frame he ended up missing a red that he would pot really, well, probably 10 times out of 10, never mind 9. Things can go wrong if you just take your eye off the ball.
28.
Yes, and would like to have played for that red closest to the left corner there, which is stopping the black going in that pocket. Just making things a little awkward, may have to play up for the blue.
29.
Now, may be able to get to that red.
Thirty-five.
Doesn't have to play for the red now, because he can play for reds to the left corner. Takes him to the black.
40. Forty-one.
48.
Well, Mark Selby potted one ball in the first two frames.
56.
But he was never been one to panic, has he? Just was waiting for his chance to get involved in this match.
57.
Yes, great belief in his own ability. He knows that his chances would come if he didn't panic.
52. Got to the semi-finals here last year, lost out 9-4-2 and inspired 62. John Higgins. And this is the thing about the world rankings, he's got this big lead, partly because he's been winning tournaments such as the World Championship with the big first prizes, but also very rarely goes out early in tournaments. He's a regular at this sort of stage, racking up the points, the prize money.
63.
Black. And Stuart Bingham needs a snooker.
And again, the crowd knowing that that was frame ball.
70.
Yes, and no mistake this time. Last frame he did miss frame ball.
71 78 79.
High spread still 145, obviously can't get near that, but chance to make a century.
86.
He's 433rd. He makes it.
87.
Yes, he's had four this week.
94. Fortunately, he won't need that safe red on the cushion to make the century.
95.
Pure class.
102.
Bingham had a 127 in the second frame. This is Selby's first century of the match. It's turning into a really good match already. And that's a cracking pot with the rest down the cushion.
100%.
Well, Black comes off the table, but he's made the century. 103. Mark Selby then, from 2-0 down, has hit the front in this semi-final and done so in fine style. A lovely break of 103. He leads Stuart Bingham in Darching by 3-2. Mark Selby getting frame 6 underway. He leads now 3-2. He was 2-0 down. Stuart Bingham just got a little bit to think about, having seen Selby come to the party with that century break.
Yes, and it all stemmed from that poor positional shot when Bingham was in amongst the balls and just left himself hampered over a red from such an easy black. Finished up losing that frame, could have gone 3-1. Great snooker though, this from both players. played the double kiss back to Bok, but that went all wrong. Didn't catch the red full enough. And could have left something easier. This is a tough red to the right corner with the rest. Got to try and avoid the black.
Stop moving, please. Stop moving.
Good pot. Very, very good rest player.
One. That's okay.
Choice whether to play for the black or play up for the blue again. Looks like he's choosing the black. Wants to get it back on its spot as soon as possible. To go past it, played to go past the red.
Eleven.
I could have choice of reds to left and right corners, and now this is a tough red. Looks like it will go to the yellow pocket though, so still a half chance, but a tough one this. Right in the middle. What a great shot. Well, seems to have the bit between his teeth now. Mark Selby, really striking the cue ball well. Well,
19.
Is he on the red? Played for the red to this right corner, but just hit it a little bit too hard. Can he get to the potting angle? Nope. So let off for Stuart Max Bingham.
19.
Well, he's found a plant, and he's played it well. Had to go in because he was leaving a red to the middle, had it not. So Stuart Bingham with a chance, and you feel he's got to take it. Don't want to go two frames behind, especially with Selby starting to play well.
Nine.
Now, delicate positional shot. If he does try and play the cannon to that red to the right of the black, above the black and to the right, or he could just decide to go into them. Could even play for the red by the brown. He's got lots of options. Played played the cannon to the red and mishit that completely. Had to miss 16. That red. That was above the black. And that's end of break. He's looking at the possibility of a three-ball plant. These two players taking anything on at the moment. Surely this is risky, there's gaps between the reds. Well, what a brave shot to take on. 17. He held his hand up for some reason, not sure.
Well, he's apologising for being on the plant, but there's nothing wrong with this. It says a lot about how he's feeling that he took that on.
Played for the chance of two reds, the red above the black, and this one into the left corner. Could have done with that cue ball just going another foot or so. This is tough. Make them look so easy. They're tough shots. Well, he's got reds that will go to the middle pocket after this one, or he could decide to go into them. Hasn't left the best angle on the black to go into them. Only just hard enough that.
36.
Very nearly snookered himself. Yeah, good shot. Those are difficult shots, and the red above the black now will pot to that right corner. Might just be able to bring another red into play here.
44.
Yep, he's got the chance.
45.
And that's opened things up. And this has turning into a frame winning chance. In fact, he'd be disappointed now if he didn't win the frame at this visit.
Well, it's been a tale of two plants. The first one to get in initially, and obviously Mark Selby 52. Hadn't considered that there was a plant on, and then the one earlier on, the three ball plant, when he'd lost position.
53.
This is shaping up already to be a cracking match.
Yeah, already is, isn't it? Two centuries already. And another four breaks over 50. Five with this one. Could be another century.
61.
This is snooker of the highest caliber.
Yes, in this very competitive era, everyone who's kept on their toes, and you know you've got to,
66.
At this stage of a tournament, produce the goods.
67.
And they're both producing the goods in this match. Snooker's required, looks like 3-3. Mark Selby made 103 previous frame.
75.
Bingham, though, stay positive. There's proof in terms of the plant that he took on the second one, which, had that gone wrong, he could have left reds on. But he was thinking more about what could go right if he potted
80.
It, which is a good attitude to have.
81.
It would be his 300th century, a little milestone for Stuart Bingham if he can make it here. Only the 16th man to do that in professional competition.
89. 92.
What a great break this has been. Never been out of position apart from the two
96.
Plants.
.300 career centuries for Stuart Bingham.
Now, all the way around the table. Oh, what a shame.
Well, he made the century, that's the important thing for him. And it means that we're all square at three frames all. This is cracking stuff. We had three centuries in six frames between these two, with two more to come in this session. Well, if you got up early to watch this, you made a good decision. It's been cracking stuff between these two. 3-3. We've had three centuries. Bingham 2, Selby 1. 2 frames left to be played in the session.
Yeah, he was up quick there, Stuart Bingham. He knew he'd brought the red up the table. Hasn't left it on. Excellent speed. The ball on the way down, missed it on the way back up again.
Mark Selby 4.
Can Selby be tempted by this red?
Okay.
Now back it goes.
That's the Hawkeye technology. It certainly helps, doesn't it, when it's that clear. Ooh.
No, can he... Oof.
Foul. And a miss.
Can he see a red full ball? I don't think he can.
Mark Selby 4.
Yeah. Soon find out.
Yes, of course, if he can, he gets warned that it's in the frame. If he misses again.
Yeah.
No warning.
Was.
Selby amusing himself by suggesting that the rule has changed to half ball contact rather than full ball on the miss. It's amazing how relaxed some of these players manage to keep themselves in these big matches.
Wasn't far away. As he left the red, I think it's just travelled that little bit too far. Easy enough to play safe off. Although if he plays the cue ball into the jaws of the green pocket, he puts Mark Selby under a little bit of pressure. Could have just skimmed off the pack of reds and left the cue ball down by the green pocket.
Obviously, whatever happens in these two frames, it's going to be tight coming back this evening. And it could be, I think it will be, a high-quality session. It's worth remembering the head-to-head between them coming into the match stood at 9-8 to Selby. And it's just sort of omen there, isn't the best of 17? Could well end up being the same later on. We'll see.
Didn't want to see the black go on the cushion. Neither player likes to see that black out of commission. And a long red. But only the blue that he can play for. Oh, what a great shot again. In fact, caught it too well. Look where the cue ball is. They're tough shots as well. I don't think there's much value in playing for the black. Can get to another red. So back up for the blue again, I would imagine.
Seven.
Now looks like the pink goes to the right corner. And there is a red that will go to the left corner. Help if the pink goes on the black spot.
Fourteen.
Well, lots of action on the cue ball, but that second kiss on the pink has just ruined things. If he hadn't been hampered over the reds, he might have taken the yellow on. But might be able to get in behind the yellow off the pink.
Mark Selby, 14.
And that will do nicely. It's a snooker.
No.
Yeah, the yellow masking a lot of the table, as you can see.
Could try and come off the black cushion and land up to the red nearest the black spot. Coming off two cushions. Not sure if the middle pocket is in the way. Playing the two cushion escape. And well, didn't get anywhere near.
Mark's out before. Well, it must be closer to the yellow then, because... Pardon? Can we have it up, please?
I was going to say, if you've got the technology, then why not just use it? Then everyone knows, everyone can see where it was. So that's what they're doing.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you.
A little closer.
Foul. And a miss.
And a free ball. It won't be going back now.
Mark Selby, four.
That is the last thing he wanted. Well, the last thing he wanted, I guess, was to leave a red on, but it's the same difference, really.
Yep, the yellow counts as a red. He's over hit it.
Three.
Always looked a little heavy. Extended rest called for. So attempting to pot the red to the left corner, screw off the reds. Maybe go down for the blue or the pink. Make sure of the red. Too hard for the pink, not hard enough for the blue.
Four. It's touch and roll. Please declare. Declare is in what colour?
Just touching the cue ball there, leaving it awkward.
Mark Selby, four.
Well, he was going to roll up to the reds, but knew he was going to be in trouble next shot. So he decided to play a very, very tough safety and played it well.
He really did. It was horrible, the shot he had. But look where he's got the white.
And a good reply. Terrific reply, in fact.
Yes, Selby's safety first couple of frames was not too good by his standards, but as the match has gone on, he's found his game, all elements of his game. He leads 34-0. He's looking, I guess, for another opening here to go in front again.
That's not a bad reply from where it was. This red is on to the corner, but it's fraught with danger. Cue ball could be going into the reds. If you could miss them, it's worth taking on. But it looks like he could be going into that red by the pink spot. So unless he plays it with a lot of stun, and he's got to avoid a lot of reds then. Great pot. Couldn't avoid the reds. So that red had to go in, but look where the cue ball's landed. Right behind the pink. And he'll be happy with that. Couldn't have dropped any better. And I suppose you could say that he deserved to be on the pink from such a good pot. And the courage to take it on.
Well, he's back in.
Seven.
Pink Eight. And black tied up. Cue ball just kept on running.
Yeah, if he plays for the red, that's just above the pink. That would release the pink into the right corner. So that would be a good red to play for here. And that's the one he's played for. Doesn't have to play for the pink, but it gives him the option of doing so. And now the pink is free. 47 points the lead. 52 with the blue. So it's getting there.
He seems in a good mood in general. He's been making the odd little aside. Just tells you that he's relaxed.
19.
And that cue ball tells you is relaxed as well. Look at where it's landing each time. Perfect position. Spot on. On a tanner, they used to say.
A long time ago.
We'll use a piece of string now.
24.
On a piece of string.
Blue to lead by 64, red and a colour to follow. Snooker's required.
Thirty-one.
Well, this is really good stuff, isn't it, from both players. I mean, some good safety in this frame. And it was a winning shot. That's one Selby this frame. Knocking that long red in. Cue ball going into the reds. He couldn't avoid them. So that red had to go in. Made absolutely sure of the pink. So one snooker to tie. So I'd like to see this red disappear. And in it goes. And again, look at the cue ball. Inch perfect.
Forty-three.
Well, there is a century on, but where the black is, it's going to be difficult.
Well, if there was to be one, that would be three on the spin 50. In this match. Four in total.
51.
Got to develop the black then this time round. Tried to move the black.
58.
Well, we've still had in seven frames 3 centuries and 5 half-centuries between the two of them. Which is pretty good going, isn't it?
Mark Selby, 58.
And Mark Selby's 58 launch with a cracking red has put him in front at 4-3. So one more frame to come in the opening session of this semi-final. Stuart Bingham will be looking to level up, and we'll see how he gets on here in Darching after this short break. We've had, in fact, 71 century breaks. Well, Mark Selby will be feeling pretty chipper about the way his game's improved over the course of the match. Early on, first two frames, only potted one ball, but things have turned around and now he's in front.
Thank you. Final frame of the session. Mark Selby.
It's been a quick fire session. Mark Selby still very relaxed as he breaks off in the last frame, leading 4-3.
And he's brought a red down the table again. And this time he hasn't covered it. Not a good break off from Mark Selby. And the way these two have been playing, it could be an expensive, poor break-off.
One.
Well, just one red out. So I would imagine, with him having such a good angle on the blue, to go into that cluster. Unless that's a plant to the left corner. Well, he played for the loose red.
Six.
So I can only assume that that was a plant. Can't see enough of it there.
Stuart Bingham, six.
And that's a disappointment for Stuart Bingham. So that must be a plant to the left corner. Mark Selby not playing the cue ball down the table.
Seventeen previous meetings between them, but they've never actually played a two-session match against each other before.
Oh. Yeah. That's a terrific pot, but the cue ball has just travelled too far.
That would have been ideal if he'd have missed the red for the white to finish there, but potting it, he wants to be on a colour. But what a great pot. Just surrendered in the end, didn't it, to the pocket.
Yeah, good pot to the middle, but couldn't get on a red. And now may play off those two reds. I did a plant to the left corner.
Eight.
Taking the red on. Not refusing anything either, player.
Stuart Bingham, eight.
Well, that would have been a candidate for the best nine break ever. He was on the black to continue, but the red stayed out. They've both been good in all departments. OK, Selby's safety early on wasn't great, but it got better. There's been the heavy scoring that we've mentioned. And also, very attacking snooker. They're going for the shots. It's not been negative. Just been good match snooker between the two of them. It is, after all, world number one v world number two. Well, someone's phone.
Switch it off, please.
He's going off.
Maybe a chance to move that plant so that we can get back to the conventional safety methods. It was a very risky shot to take on, and he's left it. Didn't want to go 5-3 down, Stuart Bingham. But now it's out of his hands. Again, he's got the choice whether to go into them or play for that loose red. Well, you can see how positive these two players are.
Six.
Stuart Bingham attempting that red to the middle. Mark Selby could have played for that loose red. Chance to go into them, and what a chance.
Yeah, how well did he play the split? Help yourself time.
We're giving him this red, but it's still a tough one. Especially with all the reds split like this, there's pressure on this. But at the moment, he's playing without pressure. Or at least enjoying it. Seven. Oh, the cue ball has just gone a little too far. He could have been guaranteed to be on a colour if he'd have played for the blue. Chose to play for the black. And now he's in a little bit of a dilemma because it's difficult to play safe with that red in the balk area. He might have to take this pink on to the middle. Doesn't go to the corner. Yes, everything was on that shot.
Mark Selby, seven.
And he's left reds on. Although he's not ideal on anything. The red to the green pocket is tough.
Well, when he split the reds, it looked like possibly frame over, but it went wrong immediately. Just overran for the black. Left himself the horrible pink. But the same applies for Bingham with the reds where they are. He's going to have to pot this.
Yeah. It was a little fortunate there, Mark Selby. The kiss on the green, otherwise he would have been ideally on that red in the balk area. Great pot. And he's on the pink. Easier to stretch over than get the long stuff out. But got to be right behind the shot. But full stretch. Got to keep that toe on the floor. Not out of the woods yet though, that red on the black cushion, closest to the black cushion. It's in an awkward position. This red to the right corner, easy enough. But the positional side of the shot, not straightforward. Didn't know
eight.
How the cannon was going to come off that red, and he's out of position. Could play the green and leave the cue ball the other side of the red, so the cue ball near the green pocket, but he still leaves that long red on to the right corner. That's the situation.
Stuart Bingham, 8.
So a rather tense finish to the session, 4-4 or 5-3. It's going to be close either way, but obviously Bingham ideally wants to level up and make it effectively a best of nine this evening.
Foul.
Oh, he's not and made it.
Mark Selby.
Yeah, he was trying to leave it very close so that he couldn't stun in behind the black. If he hits this a little hard, it's an easy snooker. Has to go back, surely. It'll be easier next time round if he puts it back. Quite.
2 hours playing time. It's not been slow by any means.
Yeah.
No, that wasn't a good attempt to get in behind the black. That cue ball should have been tight to the cushion. Where's that cue? Where's that red? And can Stuart Bingham see it? I think he can. That was very unfortunate to get the kiss on the red, send it over the pocket. Can he see enough of it? May have to swerve round the red to pot it. This is where you need Hawkeye, just to show us. Yeah, slight swerve, look. Well, he played the big pocket, and that could be the end of this frame. Look at the reds. Very tight, doesn't it? Doesn't need to play that red. He's got a red to the other corner. It's a little tougher, but he can reach it.
One.
No problem.
Well, I said, help yourself time before, and he didn't help himself to very much, but I suspect this will be a better contribution for Selby, who potted one ball in the first two frames, but has improved in all areas. And I go back to what I said earlier on, he's been so relaxed in himself, he
Six.
Has concentrated well, but just looks to be enjoying it, which is half the battle. Could have been 3-1 down at the interval when that respot frame, which he'd failed to kill off earlier on.
Seven.
The fear for Bingham, I think, is that we've seen in the last month he's played really well in semi-finals and lost them. He played really well against Selby in Shanghai, lost 6-5. He played brilliantly against Liang Wenbo in Manchester, lost 6-5. And he's played well in this match, two centuries, but could be about to go 5-3 down at the halfway stage.
12.
Yes, he had a good chance there, Stuart Bingham. Big pocket into the yellow pocket. Would have fancied him for that. Oh!
13.
That only just struggled in. So, 8 points in front.
20.
And all the reds in potable positions.
26.
Oh, we screwed that a little.
26.31, 32.
Yeah, I want it to be a little straighter on the yellow. The cue ball's going into the red if you pot the yellow. So he'd have to play it with a little bit of stunt. And there was no way that he could leave himself the easy red that he wanted.
34.
But a great rest player. 20 players hold the rest in the left hand while they're taking the shot. Most of the players press down on the rest so it doesn't move, but he holds it in his hand. One of the few players to do that.
35.
So not safe yet, 24 points the lead. Needs both these reds. That's okay.
37.
An inch slower, and it would have been a tough red. And that's not ideal on the pink. He seems to be straight on it. So I may have to take the blue. Or leave himself a long red. If he puts the pink, he'll be 33 points in front. Well, he has got a slight angle.
Switch it off, please.
Not a good time for a mobile phone to sound. Selby two balls from 5-3. So it's all on this then, for Mark Selby. From 2-0 down, he would have won five of the next six frames.
Mr. Reliable with the rest. And that wasn't easy.
So Stuart Bingham has played well. He's had two centuries, but he's going to be behind coming back tonight. Very hard to get under Mark Selby's skin, to rattle him.
49.
And he's looked relaxed, he's played some good stuff. Been strong in all areas after losing the first two frames.
51.
Three centuries and six half centuries between them for eight frames of snooker. It's good stuff.
58.
They'll have just under 3 hours to collect their thoughts before the final session.
63. 69.
So it's advantage Selby.
76 on the
frame. Terrific clearance of 76 to end the opening session of the semi-final. Stuart Bingham dominated the first two frames and had two centuries himself. Selby also a century. A lot of breaks flying in between them. Some good snooker in all areas. And Mark Selby clearly the happier of the two. He's got a two-frame advantage with nine the target to play Ding Junhui in the final. He leads Stuart Bingham 5-3.